Greetings. In the previous video, we discussed about trophic level. Today, we will learn the energy flow in ecosystem. Energy is the capacity to do work. Biological activity requires utilization of energy, which ultimately comes from the sun. Let us see how sun is the ultimate source of energy. How solar energy is transformed into chemical energy during the biological fixation of solar energy. Biological fixation of solar energy. Plants synthesize food with the help of solar energy and inorganic substances like nutrients, carbon dioxide, water vapor in a biochemical process called photosynthesis. So, plants convert sunlight into chemical energy, stored in the form of glucose, sugar. This process allows plants to grow and form the basis of the food chain. The energy used for all plant life processes is derived from solar radiations, and this is known as the biological fixation of solar energy. This process allows plants to grow and form the basis of the food chain. The photosynthetic equation involves photoautotroph. Some autotrophs, however, utilize energy released from oxidation processes for the synthesis of organic food. Transfer of energy to primary consumer, herbivore. In this illustration, you see how the food is transferred from primary producer to primary consumer or herbivore. Food is the fixed energy of photosynthesis. Herbivores feed on plants and obtain energy from the stored chemical energy within the plants. They convert the plant material into their own biomass, storing some of the energy that was initially captured from the sun. Transfer of energy to secondary consumers, carnivores and omnivores. Now, the herbivore is the source for the carnivore that feed on herbivore. The grasshopper is eaten by the frog, and the energy is transferred to secondary consumer. Secondary consumers, such as carnivores and omnivores, consume primary consumers. They obtain energy from the stored chemical energy in the organisms they consume. In this way, energy flows up the food chain from producer to the grasshopper and then to the frog. Transfer of energy to tertiary consumers, top predators. The frog is eaten by the snake. So, in this example, snake is the top predator. It takes the energy from the frog or other carnivores. The energy is transferred to the top of this food chain. This is how the energy flows and reaches the top carnivore. Tertiary consumers, which are top predators, feed on other carnivores or omnivores and obtain energy from them. They represent the highest trophic level in the food chain. Now, let us define energy flow in the ecosystem. Energy flow in an ecosystem can be defined as the transfer of energy from the sun and up each subsequent level of the food chain. Energy flows in one direction. Energy enters ecosystems as sunlight and is captured in chemical form by photoautotrophs like plants and algae. Each level of energy flow on the food chain in an ecosystem is designated by a trophic level. Each subsequent step in the food chain is equivalent to a new trophic level. Now we arrive at the most important stage in the flow of energy. Imagine what would happen when the organisms die. Please remember, when an organism dies, it becomes the food for the decomposers. Decomposers like bacteria and fungi and detritivores break down these organic matters. During decomposition, energy is released back into the ecosystem as nutrients. This decomposition process is crucial for nutrient cycling and the recycling of energy in the ecosystem. The nutrients are taken by the plants as root uptake and synthesize the food during photosynthesis. So, decomposers have very crucial role in the recycling of nutrients and energy in the ecosystem. To summarize, the chemical energy of food that are fixed by green plants flow from one trophic level to the next through the food chain. All these organisms, when they die, are decomposed by decomposer or detritivores. The product of decomposition are the nutrients for the plants and are taken as root uptake to be recycled in the ecosystem. Energy flow is a fundamental process that sustains life in ecosystems. It influences population dynamics, community structure, and the overall functioning and stability of ecological systems. Efficient energy flow and nutrient cycling are essential for maintaining the health and balance of ecosystems. Now you can try to answer these questions. Define energy flow in ecosystem. Define biological fixation of solar energy. Describe the role of decomposers in energy flow and nutrient cycling. Explain how energy flow takes place in detritus food chain. Thank you for watching. In our next video, we will understand ecological pyramid.